My dear students, how are you all? Hope you all are keeping fine. Our today's new chapter is, that is chapter 4, Sharing. Can see the book, page number 25. Please all of you look at your book here, Sharing. Sharing is caring. Sharing is the best way to multiply your happiness, is to share with each others. Sharing multiplies happiness, and it is a good habit. And by sharing also we can make a good friends, our friends, make them happy, and then we can love by sharing our things. We must not expect anything in return while sharing. We should not expect anything in return. So let's read here. When we are playing with our friends, we need to share. When we are in our small groups, we need to share. It is good to share toys with your brothers and sisters, tiffin with your classmates, and other things too with friends. It says that when we are playing with our friends, we need to share our toys, our whatever playing things we have. All these things we have to share with our friends, also with our brothers and sisters. And tiffin also in the class, we can share our tiffin with our classmates and with other friends too. When we share, it shows we care. When we are sharing our things, we are showing that we care for them. Also, we have more friends if we share. If we can share more, we can find many more friends. Success in life does not come from what we have, but from what we give. In our life, if you want to success in our life, it doesn't come from what we have. What we have now, it does not come with that. But what we give, whatever we are giving, like sharing our things or caring for others, all these things gives us success in our life. Giving someone a present is one type of generosity, but giving your time, your talents, or your friendship can make an even bigger difference. Okay, whenever we are giving a present, it is a kind of a generosity, that with love or with happiness you are giving it. But in spite of that, we can give our time, our talents, of your friendship, a bond of a friendship, that is a bigger thing. By helping them, by caring them, by showing them love, by sharing your things, by respecting your friendship, all that makes a difference. Now you can give a friend, you can give to a friend in need, someone who is struggling, or to your community. The great thing about giving is that you can do it anything and anywhere. You just need to think about others and how you can help them. So you can give to your friend when your friends are in need. Someone who is struggling, who wants help, who is in a big problem, that time you can help them. The great thing is giving, that you can do it anywhere or anytime. You can do all these things anywhere. Wherever you are, far or near, you can help them. Just you need to think about others and how you can help them. You have to think how you can help them. So here are some points I'll read for you. Sharing is caring. Number one, the meaning of life is to find your gifts. The purpose of life is to give it away. Hence, whatever we have, we can give it to others. Whatever we know, we can share with our friends. Happiness doesn't result from what we get, but from what we give. Happiness doesn't come from what we have, but what we give to others. Number three, no one has ever become poor by giving. Whenever we are giving things to someone, we are not becoming poor. Number four, no person was ever honored for what he received. He was honored for what he gave. Here it says that whoever is a big person or whoever is honored with respect, he or she has not received what he have. He did not get any present or gifts or honored from what he have, whatever he have, but what he has given to others, for that he has honored. Number five, life is not about giving, but giving up or giving in. Life is about giving. Number six, the true meaning of life is to plant trees and create shades for others too. That means we are a plant and we have to make and we have to create shade for others too. Means only for ourselves we should not think, but for others also we have to think. We make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give. For living we are getting what we have, but for a life we are whatever we have we are giving. We make a life by that, by giving to others we make our life. We learn, we experience all these things. Number eight, we rise by lifting others. Number nine, no one is useless in this world who lightens the burdens of another. No one is useless in this world, everyone is useful. Number 10, think of giving not as a duty but as a privilege. Number 11, you can give without loving but you can never love without giving. Number 12, as we work to create light for others, we naturally light our own way. Number 13, friends share all things. Number 14, what you do for others, God will do for you. Number 15, there are only three things which increase when shared: love, wisdom and happiness. See, whenever we are sharing our things, there are three things that increases when we are sharing. That is love, wisdom and happiness. We love to each others, we share our knowledge and we are happy of being togetherness. Number 16, be like the sun who fell in love with moon and shared all his light. Number 17, we are here in this world for each other, not for yourself but for each other. Number 18, a life not shared is not lived. Now this is a short story here, let us read. Rina wants to play with the new classroom toy, but Simi was already playing with it first. Rini goes to Simi and tries to grab the toy from her. Simi starts to cry. Rini starts yelling at Simi, "Give me that toy now." At recess, class teacher Mrs. Maureen notices that no one is playing with Rini. In this paragraph it says that there are two girls, one name is Rini and one is Simi, and Rini wants to play with a toy, a new classroom toy that is in the classroom, but already Simi was playing it first. She is playing already with that, and now what Rini did to Simi is she went and she grabbed the toys from her, and Simi started to cry. Then Rini started yelling at Simi. Then Rini started shouting at Simi and telling her that, "Give me the toy right now." At the recess time, means at the break time, the class teacher Mrs. Maureen notices that no one is playing with Rini. She goes to Rini and asks what is wrong. Her teacher, class teacher, went and asked to Rini that what has happened to her and what is wrong. Rini tells her, "No one wants to play with me. All they do is tell me I am mean." Rini tells to her teacher that no one is willing to play with me. All they are telling to me that I am very mean. I am very rude. I am very mean to others. Mrs. Maureen tells Rini, she knows exactly what is wrong. She tells her the other friends and are afraid of her because she always takes things without asking. So her teacher tells to her that you know what exactly what is wrong, but your friends are afraid of you because you are always taking their things without asking them. Then Rini says, "I don't want to make my friends upset. I just want to play with them and want them to like me." Then what she replied to her teacher is that she don't want to make her friends upset. She wants to play with them and want to be friend with them. Then Mrs. Maureen assures her, "If you would use your nicest words, ask them if they would like to share a toy or whatever you want from others." Then her class teacher told her that if you use a nice words, good words, then you can ask them and then they would like to share with you or whatever they want and whatever you want from others. But you have to use a good words, not a bad words. Then Rini replied, okay teacher, I will try. Then Rini knows that she has to share if she wants people to be her friend. Rini goes over to Simi and says she's sorry. Simi accepts her apology. They become good friends. Then Rini when knows that if she wants a good friend, good people, then she have to share her things or whatever is there. Then she goes to Simi and says that she is sorry. She is sorry for what she has done to her. Then Simi accepts her apology. Whatever she said sorry, then she accepted and both of them, they become friends. So hope you have understood this story about Rini and Simi. So here are some benefits of sharing. Sharing feels good. When we are sharing, we feel good. Sharing makes us grateful. Sharing increases trust. Sharing makes life real. Sharing means you are not alone. Sharing makes friends. Sharing helps to know our neighbors and makes neighborhood safer. Sharing helps you learn more about your friends. Sharing helps you to learn skills and knowledge from your friends. Sharing brings happiness. So these are the things from sharing we are getting. When we are sharing, we feel good, we feel grateful, we trust to each other, and we are not feeling lonely, we are not alone. We can make many friends, we come to know our neighbors, and then we know how he or she is. We come to learn from each others. We know the knowledge, we learn skills, knowledge from other friends, and also bring happiness in our life. So my dear students, this is the chapter. So please go through once again. So for your assignment, I have given some question answers. Please go through your Campus Care. You can see your TLM and you can write down the notes. Till then, take care. Thank you.